guys, this is Juho Making Stuff, and welcome to the second part of the Bandai Scout Trooper build. This time we are doing some sculpting. We are going to sculpt away those hideous joints. So let's get cracking. Okay, I skipped forward a bit and basically it's just me removing bits and putting them together. This is the trooper with the pose I chose, and the gray here is the primer that I just sprayed on the bits in the sprue, just because, well, I will paint them. I did some minor fixes on the seams that were kind of annoying me, so it's nothing major. Here and there, few fixes. I have now super glued these joints in stay, so it's rigid and it's not going to move. So this is the pose I'm going with. So next I will start sculpting to hide these horrible joints. Yeah, there will be some work. Look at the hand. It's just not going to work. I modified the fingers. They were really thick and weird looking, so took some stuff out and moved the fingers away. There's going to be the binoculars in this hand. Yeah. So next is sculpting. Haven't done that in ages, so hopefully it will go okay. All right. So we're, as said in the intro or the first video, we're using Tamiya epoxy putty. It's a two-component epoxy. So inside the box, they are actually bigger. I've been using this. Comes like a two strips of like a soft clay almost. What you do, you mix cut equal parts and just mix them, knead them until the color is like it's like a flesh tone color, and then you start to sculpt. It's pretty easy to sculpt. Dries pretty rock solid in 5 or 6 hours, I guess, depending on the temperature. It's really sticky at first, so what I used was water to lubricate my tools and hands. And speaking of the tools, this is the stuff I've used most. So toothpick, you always need toothpicks. And this tool was the one I used the most. It's called Tiran T146. It's like this kind of curved shape at one end. It's like a, almost like a hook. It's flat on this side and round on this side, and on the other end it's the same thing but totally flat. It's like a bent screwdriver. And this tool, I'm not sure if this is the Games Workshop sculpting tool, but it's like this kind of spatula thing on one end and almost like a knife on the other end. You can do really sharp things and seams with this one. And then I had a couple of loop tools from Tyranty, 508 and 509. Just didn't use this that much, but they're pretty handy. And last but not least, I had some crappy old brush. When you dip this in the water and just brush over the sculpting, you can almost smooth it out if you have fingerprints or other crap, and some minor blending can be done with water and brush. And when the putty has dried, I cut away smaller blocks from this 400 grit sanding pad, flexible sanding pad, so I can just take away all those remaining nasty lumps and bumps that may have been left. So yeah, that's basically our tools, and what we end up is something like this. You can see from the boots, I removed the nasty gaping hole in the ankle area, and you can do pretty sharp stuff with this. One thing, when it's dried, you can take your modeling knife or file. Let's see if I have spare parts here. This is a dried piece of that putty, and you can just file it and cut away parts that way. It's really hard, like rock solid. Anyways, you can do really focus like that seam line there. I can just continue it with this putty, and you can do even sharper things when it's dried, and just cut away with your modeling knife. Same thing with the other boot. This looks a bit odd when there's no armor pads, but these are the cloth parts, and some extra places that I thought needed, like hanging clothes like these. There wasn't joint there, but, or was there? Well, whatever. So I just thought it would be a bit cooler to have baggy cloth around this ring. There's a hole in there, but there will be this elbow pad, so it will be covered. I also did the back of the neck, filled it out, because there was a big hole there. Where's the backpack? There. I'm not totally sure if this was needed, but I filled the gap on the side of the back hump. I thought that there were just a bit too big gaps on the seams, so I filled them out. Not sure if it's that totally by the cannon, but yeah, looks better that way. And here's the pants. The buttocks area, I'm not sure what how's the real movie reference goes, because for some reasons I couldn't find Scout Trooper butts. online, or at least ones from the movie. So I did it so that there's this flat flap and the strap around the groin, but then I did like a cloth around it, because this cut piece thing, I guess it should go around, but that just looks pretty odd to me, so I ended up doing cloth pants around him. As you can see, I laid down some strips of cloth there to give some more extra wrinkles here and there.
Thank you. Stepping, 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 st
So that's it with the sculpting. Let's move on to painting and make this look better.